Welcome with Illustrator Snippets. This is episode 7. Today I want to show you how you can work with the Live Paint Bucket. You can make from easy shapes some really interesting artwork by just using the Live Paint Bucket and color all the small pieces in an easy way. I'll show you how it works. Do you have any questions? Do you have a suggestion for an episode? Or you just want to reach out to me? Put a comment below this video or send me a DM. Thank you for watching again and see you next time. Let's dive in. Welcome to this episode of Illustrator Snippets. Today I'm going to show you how the Live Paint Bucket works. I prepared a flower for you with a lot of small areas, so we have a lot to paint. With the Live Paint Bucket, it's really easy to color your illustration really fast. Let's get started. First, I will get the swatches in place. If you don't see this window, then go to Window and then Swatches. Then you will see this. When you open a new document, most of the time you have a lot of colors already in the swatches panel. So I'm going to work with a group I added, but you can work with any color in here or you add your own colors. Just like with a lot of tools, first select your artwork. In the last episode, we talked about the Shape Builder tool. That was a tool that we could combine spaces. So from this little area, we could combine those three. The Live Paint Bucket is beneath the Shape Builder tool. If you hold and press, you see Live Paint Bucket, but you can also use the K on your keyboard. Now you see three boxes above the bucket, and that are the colors from your swatches panel. So if I click the blue one, you will see I have a blue one now. If I go with my arrow on my keyboard to the right, it selects the next color. If I go to the right, it selects the next color. If I go to the left with my arrows of my keyboard, I go to the previous color. So I can go through these colors with my arrows on my keyboard. If you work in a group, it will only select those colors if you go left or right. You see, if I go left and I'm at the blue color and I go left, it will go to the last color. So that's why I like to work with a group, because else I have to go through all those colors and maybe I want to use only 3, 4, or 5. So in a group, it's a little easier to use. Let's start with the blue color. Let's start easy. You see a little text that said click to make a live paint group. I click here. You get this warning that some of your effects will get lost. But in this case, it's just a simple shape with no effects or brushes, so it's no problem. Press OK. You see that the red line is telling you which area will be colored. So we make all the outer leaves, make them blue. Now I switch to the orange color by pushing my arrow key to the right twice, green, orange. You see it's orange here and in my boxes above my bucket also orange. Now I can select the next area. I just click on the area and it fills it with the color. Two advantages of this tool. One, it's faster than selecting and saying which color you want, selecting and color. That's one advantage. The second is, if I wanted to select this leaf, it's really hard to select just a part of it. And with this bucket, it automatically selects the parts here in this area where it's really small. It sees all those small areas. Even if it doesn't have a fill, it just makes a fill now. So this is a really fast way to color your art. If you want this inner leaf to be one color, and you don't use a stroke, because if you use a stroke, it's harder. You just color them all the same. And we can just drag over it. Click or drag, whatever you want. And if I'm finished, I will show you how it looks without the selection lines. Because of the selection, you still see the areas. But if I'm finished, almost, I'll go to the V tool, the selection tool, V. And you can see I have my stroke on. It's also here. I have a fill color and a stroke color. So I select this again and I will delete the stroke by selecting none. And if I deselect, look, you have a beautiful flower and you can make art the way you want. You can color it the way you want. I will go a few steps back to show you if you want to color the inner parts all separate, that's giving another effect. Select all, we already did that. Push K on your keyboard or select the Live Paint bucket from your menu. I selected the red color now, so I will do only the inner leaves. And I want to look how it looks. I have to say stroke none because I did undo, so that was undone too. So the stroke off. Now you get this effect. So if I click it again, push the K on my keyboard to go to the Live Paint, I can go on. Select the greenish color and well, maybe I select those three together. What's good to know, the bucket, in a lot of programs, the bucket is the selection area, but here it's the little arrow. If I try with the bucket, you can see it's not lining up. So the little arrow is your selection part, not the bucket. It could be frustrating if you don't know, because then it won't select what you think it's selecting. So, oh, now I made a mistake. Good that it happened, because I accidentally also selected this leaf. So I do Command C to undo and do it again. And you can see that the red line is telling me what I have selected. So you can see what it's coloring here. Now the orange part is selected and now this little part. So if I do this again and I by accident go too far, it selects the orange and they both get green. Command C and just select those three areas you want to color. V on your keyboard to go to the selection tool, click to deselect, and you see we have a beautiful flower. So you can make really interesting and complicated things while they actually are really simple. So I hope you enjoyed this lesson and I can't wait to see what you create with this technique. If you have any questions or suggestions for my episodes, let me know in the comments or send me a DM. Thank you for watching. Until next week.